Off the bat, I'm gonna warn you, the song isn't for the faint of heart. It's a good challenge for 2013. We're gonna step up our game from pop basic chords. I'm gonna go to something a little bit tougher. Now, keep in mind, you don't gotta play it in the first day. Just take it slow and steady and do it at half speed. Blah, blah, blah. You gotta tune your guitar down. I'm gonna say that a couple times. Tune your guitar down and down. To a half step below, and that'll get you to where you need to be. If you have a song request of your own, watch this. Click that link down there. It'll say, you know, request link in the description part. And then that takes you to where you need to be to get to me so I can get back to you. Anyways, let's stop babbling and zoom in for a closer look. So that's basically what the intro and the verse is. Now, the intro part, I'm going to combine all the guitar parts. So in case you're a one guitar player guy, you can do it. So we're going to do a G chord with our second finger, third fret, E. We're going to tuck our ring and pinky on the B and E third fret. And we're going to mute out the A with our second finger. A really quick down up. Now, from there, we're gonna go to the third fret of the G and pull it down. And then go to an open G. And then we're gonna go hammer on, open D to the third fret. So we got. Again. And I've been down that D string a little bit as well. Then the next version of that riff. And then, so we go, and then we're gonna pull off, and then catch the first fret of the A string. So we got, so it's gonna be like an F chord, but you're gonna have that like you're doing that G chord on the bottom. So it's gonna be second finger, D string, third fret, first finger, G string, second fret, and then these guys are still tucked in on the third fret of the B and E. Then you're gonna take off your third finger, or your second finger rather, and move up your first finger to the D string, second fret, and then put it back to the original chord. So we got. So you add that all together. We're gonna do that twice, and then that's gonna get us into the verse. Now the verse is pretty quick. The strum pattern is pretty quick, but it's not that hard once you get the pattern. So rather than trying to explain 35 ups and downs, I'm just gonna play it really slow and then let you guys build up the speed. So we got, it sounds like this all together. Okay, did you get all that? All right, good. We're moving on. No, I'm just kidding. So we got... Again. One more time. And one more time. Now you're gonna do one pattern each time, each chord. So we're gonna go from G to C, G to C, just like normal, twice. So G, C, G, C. The third G, we're gonna add a quick little down up or whatever, and I'll show you. It's hard for me to explain it. I've tried to explain this and play it at the same time, but it's just not working. So I'm gonna play it and show it to you. So it's... And then we're going to go to B flat, which is going to be first fret A, and then I'm going to use two fingers, and I'm going to be on the D and the G, third fret of the D and G. I just said that. Third fret of the D and G. Woohoo! It's a long night, folks. So we got... And then... Back to that C add 9 chord. After that, we're gonna do a... So that's gonna be third fret. This is all on the A string. First fret, open. First fret, open. G, and then right back into the C add 9. Okay, so here we go all together. Now up to speed. All right, now that's going to bring us to the chorus, which is the exact same chords. We're just going to do the rhythm a little bit different. So we got... So, same as usual, we're going to do the first two parts normal. And we're just going to do two downs on the G, and then we're going to do our F, and then two on the C. Back to the F. So we got... Now, I hear a little hammer-on on the acoustic guy's part, could be imagining it, but all I'm doing is going to that, you know, when we switch second and third finger, or first and second finger, second and third fret. On that last chord, I'm doing a little quick hammer-on, so it's, it'd be... blah, 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 blah. And that's going to get us into the next verse, chorus, and then there's going to be some fun, tricky parts coming up here. So let's go over those. We'll be right back. Okay, so a little bit tricky, but I know you can do it. We're stepping up our game in 2013. Here we go. So we got out of the chorus, just like we did in the first chorus. Now, instead of going back into the intro riff like we did in the first chorus, we're going to go to a bridge. So when you go, before you would go back into the intro, now you're going to go right back to C. Now we're going to use our second and first finger between the third fret with our second finger, the first fret with our first finger. Now when I drop down to this B flat note, I'm draping this finger across these other strings to mute them out, because I'm going to go, right? Kind of tricky, kind of a big stretch. So you can just practice doing that. Now it's okay if these bottom strings ring out a little bit. What you're trying to mute out is the D and the G. Right? All right, so I'm gonna play this. It's hard for me to describe it, so here we go. We're gonna do is we're gonna go back into the C for a minute and then back into the G for two rounds of a strum pattern. So all together we got. So you can simplify it. Now, sometimes when I play it, as I played it in the beginning while you're watching me do this part, I keep my arm going. It's just a habit, but you can really simplify it. Really? And make it that simple. Right, because there's other stuff going on. As I'm playing by myself, I try to keep the rhythm going, but when you're playing in a band situation, you got other instruments, bass, stuff holding down the rhythm, so you don't have to play as much, right? Which is one of the reasons you should get in a band, man. All right, now we're gonna do our old trusty Hendrix chord. We're gonna be on the fifth fret with our second finger. We're gonna be on the fourth fret of the D, so that's A, D, on the fourth fret. We're gonna go back to the G with our ring finger, and we're gonna go to the B sixth fret. So it's 1-2 chord, 1-2 chord, 1-2 chord. I think we do that 6 times. We're going to go into just a D power chord, which is going to be the 5th fret A and the 7th fret D. So we got. And then 8 strokes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on the D. So in review, all together, here we go. Okay, so that's gonna cover the solo part. Now, the next little out riff of that is pretty tricky. So, it's gonna take some time. You know, everybody might get a little frustrated. You know, I was like, man, this is not easy. So we're gonna take it slow, and then you can just build it up, and eventually you'll be like, dude, I got that song, no problem. All right, so let's break down that next part. so that's not the easiest part in the world, but you can do it slow and steady. So we're gonna do like we do coming out of the choruses. We're gonna go with our thumb and our plucking finger and our pick. This is what we're gonna do, right? You're like, what was that? So I use my thumb to catch the G, third fret of the low E, and then I catch the D string, fifth fret. Now I'm gonna go to my first finger and I'm gonna go third fret, E, third fret, D. And then I'm gonna make it like a G chord, right? But I'm gonna go down to the D string again and catch the second fret. Now from there, we're gonna hammer on 3 to 5 on the A, pick the D third fret twice, and the fifth fret once. Now we're gonna do the same basic idea with the C chord. First finger, third fret of the A, and then we're gonna use the G. Now this time I'm gonna use my first finger, third finger for the fifth fret, first finger for the third fret of the A and the G, and then we're gonna do the same thing. Now this second riff's a little bit different. So it's the same kind of hammer-on, and then we're gonna hit twice, and then pull off. Where the first one was, this one's, and then back into the riff. So it's, blah, 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 blah. We're gonna do that 3 times. Now the fourth time we get back to G, we're gonna go, what you're gonna do is you're gonna do a mute down and then catch the chord on an upstroke, and that's gonna be the C. So it's 3 and 5 on the A and D. Then we're gonna do an E chord to an F chord, which is 1 and 3 on the E and A, and then F sharp, and then back into G into the chorus. So we got, blah, 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 blah. Now that is basically the trickiest part of the whole song. So just take it really slow. I know you can do it. The rest of the tune, we basically already done. It's just another chorus. And then you go back into the intro for the end of the song and you are done. All right, way to go. Now I told you, not easy, right? Lots of tricky parts, but I know you can do it. Take it slow, take it steady. If you got a song request, you're like, dude, it's too hard, there's the link down there. I'll do something nice and soft and pillowy and easy for you. But, you know, I want to step it up just a little bit. I know all you guys out there have learned tons of songs, and it's like, you know, it's good to challenge yourself. Don't always do what's easy. And, you know, just kind of step it up, and slowly but surely, you'll be there. You'll be up on stage, and people will be like, dude, you rock! Or, dude, you rule! I love you! And that's, you know, fun. So, as always, thank you so much for watching. Catch you next time.